one God who has given us the grace to celebrate this very special day in our lives, the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary is a very important day in our life because it is not just the birthday of Mary, but the birthday of new humanity. And not only the birthday of new humanity, but the birthday of new creation and the life of grace. Because of this day, God is telling us that He is a God of possibilities and is a God of new possibilities. When I was reflecting about this day, there are three truths about God that came into my mind. And from the readings, those truths have been affirmed. One, that God is a faithful God. He makes His promises and He fulfills them in our lives without looking at who we are, but He's a faithful God who fulfills His promises. The second thing that came into my mind is that God is able to build our lives from His roots, able to begin again with us, able to heal our lives. God is able to lift us when we have fallen. We may be unable, but God is always able. The third truth that came into my mind as we celebrate this day is that God is love. God who does not give up on His people, and from the worst of our lives, He brings out the best because of His love. This should give us confidence today as we celebrate this great day to come back to God and believe in Him and surrender to Him the course of our lives. When we think about Mary, and when we celebrate Mary, we remember the following things about God. One, in my opinion, the most powerful word that God ever used to create a new world. You know, God has created the world by His word, and He continues to create our world by His word. And in my opinion, the most powerful word that God ever used was, nothing is impossible to God. Nothing is impossible to God. And today, as we celebrate the birthday of the Virgin Mary, God is reminding each and every one of us to believe and to be convinced that nothing in our life is impossible to God. Life may be hard, but not impossible to God. Things may be messy, but not impossible to God. Things may be difficult, but not impossible to God. Things may be scattered into pieces, but not impossible to God. We may be frustrated, but it is not impossible to God. So today, God is calling upon us as we celebrate the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary to remind ourselves that nothing in our life is impossible to God. And since nothing is impossible to God, God is calling upon each and every one of us to surrender our lives to Him. To surrender our lives to Him. We pray for the grace surrender all to God this morning and allow Him in a special way to make our life possible. The final thing that we celebrate today is the power of God in the pieces of our lives. Sometimes whether we are going to make it in life because of who we are. But there is something very interesting today, and I know many of us will be asking, why did the genealogy of Jesus? The genealogy of Jesus reminds us of the power of God in the broken pieces of life. That genealogy mentions five women, but four of those five women were not the very best of women. That genealogy mentions very weak people, but in their weakness, God used them. Many times in our life, God uses weakness to make a witness. And all of us who are here, sometimes I know things may be difficult, but you must be convinced that God is making a witness out of a weakness. Therefore, we must not be threatened by our lives. His hand and his power will bring back the pieces of our lives. That's why we need to pray that God may bring back the pieces of our lives. God may reveal the pieces of our lives. Wherever we are, whatever has fallen down, whatever has been broken, particularly our hearts and our hopes, that God may reveal the pieces of our lives. We are seeing God who does not choose. He rides straight with crooked lines where there is fear. Therefore, dear friends, it is not just the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let this be a birthday of a new beginning in each and every one of us. Let it be a birthday of newness and freshness in our faith, that even though we walk in faith, God will continue to work, and his work will bring grace in our lives. We conclude today like Mary by surrendering our lives to God by saying, I am your handmaid. Let what you have said be done to me. What is God saying? Nothing is impossible. May what God has said be done in our lives. Kawono wabiro kawagwane nyasayo kamano. Kumudio cheng nyuol barmin wabikra maria. Kitu kawono kakamin wabikra maria. Wachiwo ngimawa. Ngimawa mangi weche mangen. Mutingu gik mangen. Mamoko. Pek kendo late wachiwo ngimawa e lwet Nyasaye kawawacho niya, eri an jatich Ruoth, ber mondo timrena kaka isewacho. We pray for the grace together with Mary to surrender our lives and all our intentions to Jesus, who is very present in this Eucharist.